Thank you. A quick question for you Wyndham members. You can pretty much tell how old the club is by the club's number, 386. This means that this was one of the first clubs in the district. It was chartered back in 1946. It was the 11th club in District 19. And this goes back in the time when District 19 was three states. So you can imagine how far people had to travel when they went to conferences. They've been active ever since. I am going to ask their president, Paula Lemke, to please come forward and make a good welcome to our new members. Paula.
$125, they would give it to us.
because they had a system of winds continuing down the line. You all saw about that in your programs. They did give us the money, and we went ahead and started the project. So if all of you please would give a warm welcome to Keith Bishop to acknowledge this good deed.
To the Ann Smelter Church.
Remote Trust here in Fort Dodge. I requested charter funding for the first 6 months' membership. Sent it, and we received confirmation and a check. I do believe miracles do happen. To convey our appreciation, our gratitude, and another sincere thank you for this wonderful gift, please help me provide an exuberant welcome for WIDS member to the lectern. It is going to be to welcome Mr. Larry Lee Drew Young.
Facility
and especially her cooperation and patience with us. Please put your hands together to welcome WINDS member Matthew Howard.
Law in Iowa for me to put your head down on my desk. daughter comes home and she's sobbing because that boy broke her heart. And you know who that boy is? You can't stand that boy. That boy reminds you of you. How are you going to hold that baby in your arms and tell her there's life after high school, that she's worth everything on earth, and there will be someone to cherish you at some point in time? And your wife, your girlfriend, your significant other. Those are all the words that you use. Remember that, right? You know what you don't call her for me, right? Don't call her your baby's mom. How are you going to explain to her and take the pain from her to assure her that you're not going to hurt her anymore, that you're going to be there by her side, that you're going to be in it with her? How do you sit with her at the kitchen table when you have too many bills, not enough money? How do you negotiate that? How are you going to solve a problem that Sunday when you only have one TV in the house and you want to watch the Super Bowl, she wants to watch Downton Abbey? Someday you'll have the opportunity to sit at the table with your mom and your dad, and the time will be right. And you want to take the hurt from their heart, and you want to take it onto your shoulders to tell them they didn't do anything wrong, and you made your own mistakes, and you're committed to doing things differently. What are you going to say to your grandma, your grandma, that person who took you out of the shelter of life, protected you? You probably all have experiences that there's that you're walking someplace and you have a smell that reminds you of grandma's house or something she gave you to eat. Or you crawled up on a chair with her as she rocked you and told you it was going to be okay. What words are you going to use when you're holding her hand as she's leaving this life? The F-bomb won't work for that. We all have a story to say. We all have our own identity that we're trying to talk through. We're trying to create. That's what life's all about. When we face the ambiguity, the changes in life, the conflict in life, we've got to make sense about who we are. That's even harder. You've committed a crime. Because how are you going to take responsibility for what you've done? How are you going to gain understanding that led you to that decision that permitted you to take something from somebody or hurt somebody? How are you going to be able to transcend that to who you are today? For those of you who are in Toastmasters, you already know the answer to that question. Did you know this book? You've already been exposed to the adventure. You've already been able to understand the knowledge that's here, that's going to help you to create a coherent, incredible identity that will take you the next level of your life. You're not going to be stuck in your swan song. Toastmasters is going to give you a prelude to create your future. A future that will enable you to nourish hope. A future that will allow you to support the values of honor and dignity and love. A future that will build a foundation and let you step up to become a man,
training are aware that learning new skills produces belief in oneself, plus the pride and determination to improve one's quality and value. To introduce such a knowing person, please provide a happy, walking on air welcome for Shawnee.
Let's just say that learning what to say or not to say at the appropriate time can make her life a lot more enjoyable. The reason I say that is because jewelry and flowers are very expensive. Organizing your thoughts, expressing them clearly, and seeing what people have to say are the keys to success with dealing with people. You have taken the steps necessary by being involved in this organization, and as you move on with your life, you will appreciate what you have learned. Thank you for inviting me here today, and I think you'll find the skills you've learned will benefit you in the future. Thank you.
In here And as you graduate and go on to your lives outside of this facility, the other things I see that present changing winds are the dogs. That's an awesome, awesome thing that you do. The Church of the Damascus Road is another program I think that is here that will provide support for you as you go on throughout your life. Welcome to the Toastmasters Clubs. Welcome to the family. And use our resources as your support.
Thank you, Mark Twain. I think that's so true. And obviously, with the help of George. Jackie, this new Toastmaster club whom we honor today is becoming an influential Toastmaster club within our organization. You are uplifting, motivating, and influencing each other in a positive, sound manner. I commend all of you for your dedication, willingness to help yourself, and to help each other. One of the reasons I keep coming to Toastmasters is because I need to continue to practice. And if I've given a speech I've flubbed, I'd like to come back to Toastmasters and do it over, and maybe a third time, and that's the joy and the beauty of the Toastmaster organization. There's always another opportunity to get it right, to set higher goals, and then to achieve those goals. To the skilled, tenacious mentors who saw this club through to today, who made this club happen, and to the state officials who allowed this club to be, thank you. Thank you very much. This is a magnificent beginning, and I am so proud to be here today. Mr. President.
Thank you. special guest, dignitaries, changing winds. Congratulations to all of you. We've heard a lot of great speeches this morning, this afternoon. I've gained a lot from it. As a mentor, I'm not sure what my job or duties are, but I know I'm going to find out. Like a lot of things that we do in life, we don't know exactly what the future is going to bring or what will be expected of us until we're called upon. I don't know what duties I'm going to be expected of until you ask me, so be sure to ask. I will offer advice when I think it's necessary, and I'll keep my mouth shut when I don't think it's necessary. I don't want to tell you what to do. I want you to lead your own organization, and I see that happening already. I can give you advice from experience that I have had in other organizations. I will tell you some of my background and experiences I've had when we meet next time. Thank you very much.
This one has been the greatest award I ever.
Honored dignitary, welcome guests. These men behind me are not only wonderful speakers, but they are changed human beings, such as myself. We started out with one plan and one plan only, and that's to change. Each member has become family member to me. But each one of us couldn't have done it without the tools and the education from Ms. Joan Johansson and Ms. Jackie Johansson. Thank you.
many applicants to it.
I do have one question, though, for Joan and Jackie. Are you going to have room on your banner for that other room? We'll have to expand. Changing Winds Club would be remiss if we did not formally offer our deepest gratitude for all the cooperation and support given to us by another staff member. Unfortunately, that staff member could not be here today to receive this recognition face to face. He said something about going to Arizona to see a football game. Activity Specialist 2, Twanti Kaufman, has aided the Changing Winds Toastmasters Club in many of our endeavors, and has been an essential ally behind the scenes to help our club make progress from week to week. Many would say that virtue is its own reward, but we thought it necessary to provide a more concrete and tangible form of recognition. The Changing Winds Club honors Monty Kaufman for his outstanding contributions with this Certificate of Appreciation.
Membership in Changing Winds. As your name is read off, Jerry Bettinger. John Brewer. John Brown. Brian Rudis. Jamel Burton. Brian Cornwell. Sean Nay. Keith Grisham. Matthew Helmrich. Henry Jones. James Lambie. Christian Lucier. Aaron Nellis.
International.
prepared speech, but I will say from my heart, three people believed in me. My sister being one, my mother, he's extremely shy back there, but my brother, Derek Pena, who's been my roommate for the past 2.5 years. He never let me quit, and he always pushed me. And my team, they pushed me. And last but not least, I have to thank God, because he brought me out of a situation